For much of election night, Donald Trump seemed to be leading in a number of key swing states. Then early Wednesday morning, he began to fall behind. That trend continued more or less for several days. On Saturday, the media declared Joe Biden the president-elect. Biden quickly accepted that judgment. The Biden campaign now has something called the Office of the President-elect. It sounds official, which of course is the point of setting it up. And there are questions, and that means we have to answer them. For example, in Pennsylvania, Nevada, and Michigan, the Trump campaign has now collected signed affidavits that attest to criminal activity during the voting process. In the city of Detroit, witnesses have alleged under oath that ballots were improperly backdated and counted without matching signatures. One poll watcher alleges that 40,000 late unsealed absentee ballots were counted orally and all of them went for Democrats. In the state of Nevada, 8 whistleblowers from within the Nevada Election Department say they witnessed voter fraud abetted by other election officials and by their supervisors. According to one affidavit, a poll worker saw people bringing handfuls of ballots to a Biden-Harris campaign van. Those ballots were then filled out at the van, placed in return envelopes. Eventually, Biden supporters formed a wall to block outsiders from seeing what they were doing. Meanwhile, according to voting records, people who were not even alive still somehow managed to vote on Tuesday. In New York, deceased voters cast absentee ballots. On October 9th in Nevada, a man called Fred Stokes Jr. mailed in his vote. The only problem was Fred Stokes Jr. died 3 years ago at the age of 92. The Republican Party of Nevada says it is aware of hundreds of other potential cases of dead people casting ballots. In Pennsylvania, records show turnout from several people who were born in the 19th century. They apparently rose from their graves to vote. Now, all of that is real. We spent all weekend checking it. False claims of fraud can be every bit as destructive as the fraud itself. So we need to be careful and responsible, all of us. But what we just told you is true, and there's more of it. Just hours ago in the state of Georgia, an election official admitted that they will find illegal votes and double voters when they check the voter rolls.